Hello, we're with Kyunghyun Cho, assistant professor at New York University. Kyunghyun, there's been a lot of hype in the media around neuromachine translation. Can you share with us some of the more recent updates?
So that's a big question you're asking me at the moment. So I guess from the research point of view, what has been happening for the past, let's say, half a century is that the people in industry as well as the academia have been making a very small but steady progress over time. Now, of course, all those small steps accumulate and then become the disruption in the industry. Now, so instead of trying to tell you about these small changes that have been happening in the past, let's say, couple of months or so, what I'd like to point out is that it's a great time to do the machine translation, even in the industry, because what people have been doing in academia is to make all those softwares freely available and then made it easy to use. So for instance, the OpenNMT Pi, which was released by the group in Harvard and also backed by the Systron, the machine translation company, that software has been used by the booking.com to essentially implement the site-wide machine translation system for translating reviews and the descriptions automatically. And then there are more libraries like that available all over the world. And the industry as well as the academia can use it. So you can think of it as the democratization of the whole technology. So that's the most exciting thing. And then that is still being happening.
So is this what you're seeing as that first practical step then, that clients are investing in their own development using the technology that's available available through these offerings now?
I think you can think of it as a two-way street here. So the interesting thing is that the OpenNMT, the one that I just take as an example, is not only being developed by the University of Harvard University, but also backed by the Systron. And then Systron is making everything open source, available for others to use. And then the same thing actually happens. So one, let's say, most widely used machine translation library called Nematus, that is from the University of Edinburgh, was built based on the code that I have made available about 3 years ago. And then that's also freely available, and then University of Edinburgh is being sponsored by many of the industry partners. What it means is that effectively we have turned the culture around the machine translation as a natural language processing, both in academia and industry, where we share as much as possible. And then the sharing goes back into the software by investment by the companies, and then that's essentially accelerating the progress. So it's an exciting time.
It is an exciting time. So within this virtuous circle of sharing and research, what then are the one or two top challenges that you continue to face as a researcher trying to develop neuromachine translation?
So one big challenge that I'm seeing is that unlike human translators who look at the gigantic context around the text, so they're going to look at the whole document in order to translate one sentence, they're going to look into the other information sources in order to correctly select these correct words. But currently the machine translation systems, including neural machine translation, largely focus on a single sentence. So they're going to translate a sentence based entirely on what kind of information is embedded in that sentence. And that's very limiting. That's an extremely limiting factor, especially when we compare against the professional human translators. So my group, as well as other groups all over the world, have been trying to figure out how to extend a new version of neural machine translation system that can take into account not only the given target sentence, but also the document in which the sentence happens, as well as the entire society you can think of.
Okay, and does this have to do with also context in terms of culture, region, city?
Yes, precisely. So in fact, the region, cities, I think is actually, it may be even straightforward to incorporate. But yes, eventually we want to go into the case where when we have a machine translation system translate a novel, for instance, we want the machine translation system to take into account who the author is, in which situation the author wrote the novel, and then what kind of, let's say, time period is novel about. So all the things that human translators or the humans readers are going to take into account, we want machines to be able to incorporate as well.
That's a great deal of depth and context then.
That is, yes.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much.
Well, thank you.